Simon & Schuster Audio presents World of Warcraft, Wolfheart. Written by Richard A. Knaak and read by Scott Breck. Prologue Northrend. Twin rows of straining, green-skinned warriors tugged on taut, broad ropes as they dragged a colossal wheeled cage slowly up the wide ramp leading into the last of the ships. Despite Northrend's eternal winter, the muscular orcs sweated heavily from effort, their broad-jawed faces contorted with each new heave of the ropes. Guards stood alongside the ramp, torches in one hand, ready weapons in the other. With steely brown eyes, they watched not the workers, but rather the great covered cage. The cube-shaped structure towered over them, its outer covering consisting of a great tarp sewn from goatskin. There were no gaps in the tarp, no hint from the container as to just what the cargo was. But there was a clue, revealed simply in the fact that the orcs themselves maneuvered the cargo. Desolate as the port was, it did have work animals, such as the horned reptilian kodo beasts, strong creatures more than capable of taking the places of the struggling orcs. There was even a trio of mammoths, generally used for transporting several riders at once. Yet not only were those animals excluded from the effort, but they had been moved decidedly far from the vicinity of the docks. Even there they stirred anxiously, the kodo beasts flaring their nostrils and the mammoths waving their trunks as all the animals stared in the direction of the ships. With a tremendous howl, the winds abruptly picked up to storm strength. Weather in Northrend had only one consistent factor, that it was foul. But there were many levels of foul, and the docks shook as the waters of the cold sea suddenly churned with great waves. Ship hulls groaned as every vessel rocked hard. From deep within some of the ships there came horrendous roars and banging. On deck, crew members rushed to the hatches leading down to the holds. Stern veteran mariners and warriors looked anxious. The last ship also rocked, and the gangplank twisted. It dipped to one side, spilling several startled guards and throwing the workers into a tangle. The cage shifted. At the last moment, the orcs on the teetering ramp kept the container from falling. However, no sooner had they managed that than it began to shake from within. A roar identical to those emanating from the ships, but much deeper, echoed through the dank port. Something within began pulling at the tarp. Guards rushed up from the port. Those still astride the gangplank fought desperately to maintain their balance. One failed, instead tumbling into the chill waters between the dock and the ship. From the shoreline, the fleet captain, a one-eyed veteran mariner called Brilne, whose body bore numerous intricate tattoos marking his journeys, raced toward the side of the gangplank and shouted, "Get that cage straightened! Don't let it fall! Get those weapons ready! Where's the powder? If that cage is damaged..." The cage beneath the tangled tarp rattled. The dim illumination of the wind-blown torches was insufficient to reveal what was happening, but the nerve-scraping wrenching of metal gave Brilne enough warning. "Spears up front! Hurry, you offal! The right side of the cage!" Two guards, either more impetuous or more foolish than the rest, moved in closer. From his angle, Brilne could not make out everything that happened next, but he saw enough. The foremost orc prodded the cage with his spear. The next instant, something snagged his weapon and tugged both it and him through a tear in the tarp. As that happened, the second orc instinctively lunged forward to aid his vanishing comrade. Something thick darted through the tear. The orc was too slow to realize his danger. He was plucked from the gangplank as if weighing nothing. Before his fellows could reach him, the massive appendage crushed the guard's torso, flesh, bone, plate armor, and all. The gore splattered those farther back. The hand threw the limp, ruined body aside, then retreated into the covered cage. From within there immediately came a cry from the first warrior, apparently left alive for the moment. Orcs with long, thick spears quickly lunged toward the spot as Briln raced up to join them. Two guards thrust, but the captain knew that it was already too late. Shrieks that almost stopped him in his tracks echoed through the Northrend port. The utter fear in those cries could be felt as well as heard. There was little that could shake an orc's resolve, or even draw up in one anything resembling terror. But what had been captured at already so much cost was more than capable. A horrific, crushing sound punctuated the shrieks. The orcs near the opening stepped back as something liquid sprayed them. A ghastly stench immediately followed, filling their noses. "Spears! Spears!" Briln roared again as he neared. The captain looked up. The torchlight enabled him to see the rip in the tarp and the bent bars. Those bars had been forged strong. Even with all his might, the gargantuan beast had been unable to do more than pull the bars just a little farther apart. Unfortunately for the two guards, that had been quite sufficient. "Where's the powder?" Briln demanded to no one in particular. Another orc finally rushed up with a burlap sack the size of a thick fist. He also wore a coarse cloth over his mouth and nose and handed one just like it to Briln, who used the two strings attached to the piece to secure it to his own face. The mask was merely a precaution. Nothing from the sack should have ended up in either Briln's nose or mouth, but there was no sense in taking unnecessary chances. The captain was tempted to let the other orc do the task, but then he seized the sack himself. From within the nearby cage, sickening, ripping sounds continued.
"Cover me!"
The captain positioned himself, then studied the gap carefully. Although he had lost the one eye years ago in battling Kalimdor against the Alliance forces commanded by the human Admiral Proudmoore, Briln still prided himself on his expert aim. Taking a deep breath behind the cloth mask, the scarred orc tossed the pouch toward the gap. The wind gusted, and for a moment Briln was filled with fear that the sack would miss entirely. However, it just barely made the edge of the rip, then fell into the obscured cage. A moment later, the captain heard a small, soft thump. The beast within let out a distrusting rumble. There was the sound of chewing. A slight mist of powder exited the tear, but not enough to concern the orcs. The wind carried away what little escaped, dispersing it. Inside the covered cage, something heavy and moist dropped. Briln knew it to very likely be what was left of the guard. Despite that, the sound gave the captain more hope that his plan had succeeded. A confused grunt arose from the shrouded creature. Suddenly, the cage shook harder. Inside, a huge form slammed against the bent bars. Heavy breathing arose near the tear in the tarp, but nothing could be made out clearly in the tear itself. The breathing became labored, exhausted. The orcs heard stumbling. Then there came a violent thud. The cage shuddered and almost slipped again. Only the strength of nearly two dozen struggling orcs kept that from happening. Briln and the others waited several tense moments, but there was no renewed movement or sound. With caution, the captain approached the covered cage. Becoming more daring, he prodded the tarp. Nothing happened. Briln exhaled in relief, then turned to the others.
"Load that thing aboard, then get those bars bent back and that hole covered with something. Better make sure that there's always a sack of that herb concoction the shaman gave us ready to sprinkle on the thing's food. We can't afford this on the seas."
The other orcs moved to follow his orders. The captain studied the silhouettes of the other ships. Each contained such a cage. The new warchief Garrosh had commanded that this venture be completed, regardless of the cost in seeing it done. Brilne and the others here had not questioned that cost either, for all would have readily perished for the legendary overlord of the Warsong offensive. Garrosh's deeds were epic and retold over and over in the Horde. He was also the son of the late Grom Hellscream and had been an advisor to Thrall, the orc leader who had freed their people from captivity. Yes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.